I'll take it. I will take a W any way I can get it. OU wins 52-42. Gets a win over a ranked team. I mean, how do you complain about that? Oh, some of you out there will. Look, I don't know, but I can't speak for all of you out there, because I know some of you out there are still mourning the season and are distressed over all the goals that you wanted the chance to achieve. Look, I needed this. And I think deep down, a lot of you needed this. Because there are some of you out there who treat this game, you look at Kansas and you still see them as Kansas. And to an extent, they are. But, like, I'm seeing people in my chat saying, we're doing this against Kansas! It's like, guys, this ain't to win Kansas. They were playing this game to become bowl eligible. You know how long ago it's been since they've been bowl eligible? I want you to stop. Why don't you look it up yourselves and see when the last time Kansas was bowl eligible? It's been a minute. So if you still think it's, like, this crappy Kansas team that's ha-ha funny, that's not who they are this year. They did not have their starting quarterback, but their backup is good enough to make some plays. He was good enough to almost beat us last year. Jason Bean can make a few plays here and there. He's competent. We don't have anybody behind our quarterback right now because we were gutted at the position. But if there's one thing I hope everyone takes away from today, more than anything, is that I hope y'all appreciate Dylan Gabriel a little more today than you did a few weeks ago. And look, I'm not going to excuse the turnovers. He had a bad day with turnovers. He got his first pick today and had two really bad fumbles. Not going to, like, pretend those weren't bad. You go into your bye week, hopefully you can clean those up. But seeing our offense actually able to move the football, we ran the football effectively. Again, does Kansas have world beaters on their front seven? No. But it's nice to see that we're able to run the ball against somebody. Anybody. Like, Eric Gray had an amazing day today. He was making moves in the open field and just, like, little runs that would get you 3 or 4 yards would get you, like, 10 or 12 or more. Like, Eric Gray, monster game. Had, like, 170 yards rushing. Javonte Barnes had, like, 69 yards rushing. Nice. Farouk had a good day. Theo Weiss had a good day. All the drama surrounding Theo Weiss, he looked good today. Marvin Mims had a few moments here and there. The defensive side of the football, look, I know you're going to look at the box score. You're going to look at 42. Like, it's going to take a while to rebuild this defense, folks. It just is. But you see Colden making, like, the interception of the year. Key Lawrence played great today at certain points. You know, we had some moments where we're getting the backfield. You know, Isaiah Cogan, the face mask, whether he got the face mask or not or anything. But you saw moments where we got 3 and outs, forced punts. You saw a little bit of progress. You gave up 42. You scored 52. You had some moments where you had some bad drives. You had some decent drives on defense, whatever. I will take a win any way I can get it. Anyway, not going to complain today. A lot of you are. A lot of you are going to nitpick and everything, and that's fine. I'm not saying there isn't room for improvement. You go into a bye week, and you have Iowa State coming, who came very close to beating Texas today. There's a little controversy potentially at the end of that game, but it is what it is. They lost. So we are no longer in the Big 12 cellar. We are, they are 0-4. We are 1-3 in conference play. So what are you going to do with this win? What are you going to do? Well, number one, you played, and the crowd was okay today. The uniforms look good. It would have looked better at a night game, obviously, but they still look good. Maybe they gave them superpowers. I don't know what it is, but they got the job done wearing these uniforms. You had a couple of recruits today, Akana, who out of Utah, and you got Cade McDonald. Would love to have both those guys for this defensive recruiting class. Of course, Jackson Arnold, our quarterback, was in the house for leading this the centerpiece of our recruiting class, 5-star QB, saying, we need quarterback play. We need coming next year, folks. It's coming. I promise you. We'll probably have to portal some more guys or whatever, but 5-star's coming next year. We can still get those. It's okay. So, again, just kind of a blasé second half. You know, the first quarter took forever because there was, you know, there was some reviews and stalling, and, you know, thoughts out to Kobe Bryant, the defensive back for Kansas, who looked like he had a gruesome injury near the end of the first half. Had to bring out the cart, air cast. I guess he didn't have to go to the hospital. Hope he's doing okay. Wish him speedy recovery. And I know, I think one thing I took away from that moment is that we could have punched the ball in to go up three touchdowns at the end of the first half. We didn't do that. It was like left a bad taste in your mouth. But you get to the beginning of the third quarter, you force a turnover, you get the ball back from Kansas, you go down there, you get in a similar situation where you got to punch it in from the one, and you do it. So kind of made up for it a little bit. Again, this game was not perfect by any means, but based on how this season has gone, when you saw what we looked like last week and how we just got destroyed at TCU and whatnot in the Kansas State game, we look closer to what we looked like against Kansas State than we did the past 2 weeks. Offensively, still got a lot of stuff to clean up. But can this team win the rest of their games? No, not yet. I'm not going there yet. But being able to end the game, smiles on faces, you got a W, take this momentum, ball this up, take it into the bye week, some positivity. Here's what we did well, here's what we did wrong. And who knows what the season's going to turn out to be. You never know. It's not going to do anything we really want, like long term, mind you. But, you know, you finish strong, you find a way to get 8 wins, and by some grace of God, 9. All of a sudden, it's like, what a turnaround that for Coach Brent Venables, this and that. You start off like poorly and then finish strong. Then you get momentum going into next year. And you got guys coming in, potentially early enrollees, who will make an impact. And then you turn a 9-win season into maybe a 10-win season or an 11-win season. Who knows? But it looks like we're going to be in the Big 12 for a while, just based on recent happenings with TV and contracts and conference realignment. But so for those who don't want to go to the SEC as soon as possible, you may get your wish. We may not be going till 25 at this point. So anyway, that's a whole other topic for a whole other day. Right now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to chill for the rest of the day. I'm going to watch this Alabama-Tennessee game. I'm going to keep an eye on TCU-Oklahoma State and see if Spencer Sanders is going to play. And from that point on, I will be back tomorrow, do my AP poll recap. I don't expect to be ranked tomorrow despite beating a ranked team. I don't think they're going to put a 3-loss team in there. We won convincingly, but it's like, I don't think they're going to put us in there by any means yet. We need to stack up a few more W's before we crack the top 25 again. But with all that being said, thanks for all who showed up to the stream. Appreciate all the super chats and everything. For next week, I will do a watch along. More than likely, it'll be Texas Oklahoma State. If that changes, I'll let you know. But like, follow me on Twitter, social media, all that stuff down below. Like, subscribe, comment, all those good things that YouTubers say. Boomer Sooner, got a W, and I'll catch y'all later.